Hanska John. Oh, John.
Yeah, hi Benno.
Hi. You're going to explain something in a very simple way, which people perceive as being very difficult.
Yeah.
In retail.
Yes. Yeah.
Please explain.
If you're not confused, then you probably don't understand the problem.
Okay.
So, in a retail store, you have two products that you're going to sell, and later you'll pay the supplier for the products. So first, we'll pay you for the first article, and for that article, you get €3. So 1 euro and 2 euros, and I pay it.
So this is a high value product.
Yeah, a high value product, and also 2/3 goes to the factory and 1/3 goes to the store. So this has a low margin.
Yes.
And then you have another product and you get 60 cents for it. That's the selling price.
Right.
Whereby you get 5/6, so 50 cents and 10 cents goes to the factory. So this one has a high margin and very little loss going to the factory.
No, I understand this. What's the difficulty?
Yeah. So the difficulty is that in practice, a lot of stores use average margins in the store. So we look at the total store, what's going to the factory, what's going to the store, and that's the ratio.
Okay, and why do they do that?
They do that because in the past there were no computers to track it per article, so they only could work with averages.
Okay.
And then a store has sales, some money goes to the factory, and then you also have expenses, which are often expressed as a percentage of sales. And then when we subtract the expenses from the total sales, we see that all the expenses added up equal the total sales. And we'll see that here in practice. So this money on the top goes to the factory.
Right.
And when we have €1.50, which is paid for salaries, rent, and other expenses. So that also disappears.
So you have no profit.
No profit. No.
Okay.
Just break even. That's not good. So it will
take. So what happens to the CEO? He gets fired, or does he get a second chance?
In the case of our family, the CEO gets fired.
Oh.
And they bring in an outsider. So let's take a look at it, see if we can get some high margin articles.
Right.
And try to make a profit. So if we have one article that sells three times, you have it in the store, it sells, it sells, it sells.
So we're going to increase the speed.
Yes.
What's the name? The turnaround speed? What do you call that?
Yeah, the turnover speed.
Turnover speed.
And so this article gets sold once, it gets sold twice, it gets sold three times. And this is the percentage that goes to the store. And this, from the first year, was the percentage of expenses. So this looks like a profitable idea.
Right.
And the alternative is to have an article that sells twice. So once in the store, twice in the store, lower turnover speed.
Right.
And it has a lower margin. So the expenses in the factory plus the expenses percentage from the store is more than 100%.
Right.
And it looks like a disaster. And so which would you choose?
Well, if that's going to be a disaster, I will choose this, of course.
Yeah, yeah.
But and you're going to tell me it's different.
Well, you have the right answer, and also the computer systems at most retailers would say high margin, high turnover speed, that's the best choice.
Right.
But if we look at it in a different way, we say we've earned 50 cents per article on this one.
Right.
And we've earned 2 times €1 on this one.
Right.
So that's two.
Two.
Or €1.50.
Ah.
So.
Oh, that's clear.
Yeah.
If you go for the high price.
So €2 is more than 150. So it's not that much that you have to go for the high price points, but it's the way you frame the problem.
Right.
So what you have to do is count money instead of comparing margins.
Right.
And in, at C&A, we always used to say, you cannot take percentages to the bank.
That's correct, yes.
Yeah.
So, well, this is all very clear.
I hope so, and many German retailers do it this way. And then the next video, we can maybe explain how it works for the planning of the company.
Okay.